Hello and welcome back. It's the earnings season which is going on, and one such name that has declared numbers is Karnataka Bank. Let's just go across to the management. He's with us on the phone line, Mr. Mahableshwara MS, MD and CEO at Karnataka Bank. Sir, if you could just talk about the numbers, what happened, especially about the retail and the corporate slippages, what happened in the quarter?
More worried point for all the banks, but definitely not for the Karnataka Bank during the current year. In fact, the slippage ratio, which was at 2.25% as of March 21, that is the previous quarter, it has come down to 0.83%. During the corresponding previous quarter of the year, you may be aware of the fact that there was a status quo maintenance, because slippage was not there, marking of the NPA was not there. But in almost all the areas, especially the NPAs, both the gross NPA as well as net NPA, it has further shown marked improvement. So that is one plus point, because it was definitely a tough quarter in terms of asset quality management. And even under tough time, I'm happy that Karnataka Bank remained a profitable bank. In fact, the pandemic has actually acted as a litmus test in assessing the asset quality. The GNPA, which is now at 4.82%, it was at 4.91%. In terms of percentage terms, it has come down. And whereas in case of absolute numbers also, it was at 2,588 during the previous sequential quarter, and now it is at 2,549. More important is net NPA, which was at 3.18%, now it is at 3%. And absolute terms from 1,642 crores to 1,552 crores. So both in terms of absolute numbers as well as in terms of percentage, the NPAs have come down, and that is a significant observation of this particular quarterly result.
What is the way ahead? When do you see things picking up? How has July been? Have things been much better in this after things are looking to open up?
Yes, things have already started picking up. In fact, if you see the growth in the advances, so there is a positive traction in the advances growth, positive traction in deposits growth compared to the previous quarter. And we are getting good proposals also. And I am optimistic that in all the important areas where we are focusing, especially the MSMEs, agriculture, equipment loans to the contractors, and even the gold loans, where we have been able to do well in the previous quarter, the growth is picking up. And as a result, going forward in almost all the areas, it could be in the area of NII or in the area of NIM, we should be able to further improve our performance. In fact, for the current year, current quarter, NII has shown a growth of 25.19% over the previous sequential quarter. And year on year also, it remained positive at 7.41%. So NIM also improved from 2.41% during the previous quarter to current 2.98%. And as a result, our provision coverage ratio has also improved further to 72.24% from the previous quarter 70.05% and the last year's corresponding quarter 67.93%. So these are all the positive features wherein we are optimistic that going forward, the growth will pick up. And from the core sector, the bank will be able to do well going forward also. Yes, net profit for the current quarter, you might have observed that compared to the previous sequential quarter, it has gone up to 106.08 crores from 31.36.
Right.
But year on year, there is a decline from 196 crores to 106 crores. Of course, this is mainly on account of the steep decline in the trading profit. That is the major reason. Otherwise, the consistency in the core business sector, it is well maintained. And I am optimistic that growth will pick up during this particular second quarter.
Mr. Mahabaleshwar, hi, good afternoon. This is Ruchi Bhatia from ET Now. I want to ask you, you said that, as against other banks, NPAs haven't been much of a concern. But what other banks have told us is that retail delinquencies have risen quite a bit. Is that a trend that you're seeing as far as Karnataka Bank is concerned as well? And also, if you can talk to us about how the recoveries are taking shape, because we're coming out of the second wave of the COVID pandemic, and we did see some of the banks telling us that recoveries were affected a fair bit.
Yeah, that's a very pertinent question, ma'am. See, fortunately for us, we are not overexposed to any of the sectors, whether it is in the retail or the mid-corporate or even the corporate also. That is one of the major reasons while selecting the borrowers. The filters, whatever that we have applied, that has really proved remarkable. And I am also happy that borrowers have also managed their business in a better professional way. And a lot of recovery efforts in terms of our collection hub, counseling the borrowers, wherever their restructuring requirement to overcome the temporary that mismatch of the funds, all those things have been taken care of. As a result, both in terms of the NPAs as well as in terms of the stress in the portfolio measured in terms of the SME account, both have been positive, and that is the reason the asset quality has not deteriorated. In the past also, I have been observing and keenly monitoring this position also. So at any given point of time, we never had a sleepless night in managing the quality of the advances. Now, since the activities have picked up post-lockdown period, especially during this month and onwards, so definitely that will be a huge plus point for Karnataka Bank in furthering its core business activities and also further improving its position in terms of NII as well as NIM.
Okay, all right. On that note, Mr. Mahabaleshwar, appreciate you taking your time out and speaking with us today at ET Now. That's a very optimistic Karnataka Bank saying that things will pick up from here on, and they haven't had too much of a problem maintaining their NPA levels and the asset quality in this current quarter owing to various measures that the bank took. But on that note, time to get into a short break. We will be back.